while the aviation world is receiving blow after blow at the moment, out in Western Sydney, a mammoth industry shake-up is taking form out of a paddock with just a few cows grazing happily. It's the multi-billion dollar project that is Western Sydney International Airport, gearing up for takeoff in 2026, but it's much more than just the engine room from Australia's biggest city. It's what we can do when governments actually build things for our future. We got an exclusive look into how the operation is tracking. So I'm looking into the future, 2026. We're seeing a big plane come in, A380 or something like that, right over here.
Absolutely. We land on our runway, which is fit for any size aircraft, and then 5-minute taxi. Here we are standing at international arrivals. People will come off the plane and come up the escalator here, and they'll go through here and along the pier through to customs.
Let me be the first. This is a Today Show exclusive. The first passenger upstairs. I've got my bags, I've got my passport, I'm ready to check into customs.
That's right.
But it does come at a cost. $11 billion across almost a decade, made a reality by 3,600 workers across three major contractors. And if all goes to plan, 10 million passengers will pass through each year, with ambitions for millions more down the track, alongside three new terminals and a second runway. This is unlike anything we've seen in this country.
I think it'll set a new benchmark in what we should expect when we're going to an airport. It's going to be fantastic.
Just downstairs, departures are also a revolution in Australia.
So here we have what we call swing gates. From a customer perspective, they're boarding through the best gates that we've got, as centrally located as they can, and they swing from a productivity perspective, both international and domestic air priority.
I think you've thought of everything. I just need to go shopping. Where's the shopping district?
Well, let's go and have a look at our shopping.
This is what I'm talking about. This is a shopping area. It's like a Westfield.
So this is a large and beautiful space, isn't it? And this is where we're going to have our food and beverage and our retail. We're not building a tin shed. And we're really thinking about Western Sydney and, you know, the third largest economy in Australia. The diversity in Western Sydney, we're building something that's going to last for the next generation and beyond.
No excuses for losing baggage here.
Well, that's right. We've minimised the opportunity. This is 5 kilometres of baggage system that goes to a bag store just over here, and the machine sorts out when your aircraft's ready to be loaded. This is the same type of system that's in 15 of the best 20 airports in the world. We've done our homework. And, you know, at other airports, you have a belt system. This is a real automated, integrated, automated baggage system.
Zero excuses. No pressure.
You can hold me to it.
All right. And out on the job site, women are paving the way. Former ICU nurse turned safety inspector Steph Gatt, swapping the scrubs for a hard hat.
I saw victims, people in workplace accidents. I was treating them. And I thought, what better way than to be part of the prevention?
And for a project of this scale comes a sense of pride. From transporting materials...
It was all paddocks when I was here. So
really?
It's incredible to see how far we've come.
To laying the tarmac.
One day we're going to take a holiday or my, you know, future kids, and I was a part of it from almost start to finish.
But the main thing is that it's the biggest earth-moving site in the Southern Hemisphere. Our name's on it. We're part of it, and even for me personally, my grandkids will be able to say, hey, Pop, help build this.
You're getting emotional.
No.
I thought you wanted a cuddle or something.
He is getting emotional.
But not everyone has welcomed the project with the same enthusiasm. Some people are still questioning whether or not the routes are going to fly over their homes. There's consultation open to that. How confident are you it's all going to work out? Because it's going to be hard to bring all this down now.
So from the beginning, we've been engaged with community around us. The flight paths are now known, and the environmental impact statement is coming out, and people can engage in that process, and they should do that. But this is also, we get a lot of people who are looking forward to this airport opening, that travel is going to be closer for them, the jobs and the opportunities that come from this marvellous airport, the idea that Bradfield is going to be built one metro stop away. So that benefits that this brings for this entire community are very significant. Sydney's back open for business. You know, a 24/7 airport right here in Sydney. It's a marvellous thing.
Get your tickets ready.
Get ready for a seamless, enjoyable travel experience through Western Sydney International
Wouldn't
Airport.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Wouldn't it be nice?
It would be nice.
It would be.
Imagine. And it is really setting the framework for the future in Western Sydney, which is just unbelievable, the development out there.
Yeah.
But I think more widely across Australia, when state governments and federal governments get it together and plan for the future and build for the future big infrastructure projects, that's what we see. That's what we want to see.
That's the result, exactly.
Yeah. It makes a bit too much sense, though, guys.
I know, too much sense.
Need more of that.
Yeah. Common sense isn't always common.
That's, no. Thank you, Alex.
Nice work, Carlos.